Good morning, Pioneers. Wake up.
I'm awake. Okay. Sorry. Yeah, sorry. Spring break, I really missed on my sleep schedule.
What did you do?
Nothing much.
Hello, guys. This is my vlog. Alright.
Oh, but let's see what you guys did for spring break.
I just chilled, took like a rest spring break for myself because I was super exhausted, and the whole entire time I really wanted to de-stress and really just chill, maybe read some books, watch some movies, catch up on some TV shows, but I did find my prom outfit, so that's what I was really happy about.
I saw a lot of family. I went up north to Monterey County and I saw a lot of family. I just chilled, ate.
Oh, I went to Universal Studios. I went to a party. I also did an Easter hunt. I went to the aquarium with my family.
Someone hit my car.
That's awful.
What I did over spring break was finding the Easter eggs. I found the golden egg and I have like $500.
Hey, nice.
And I was the first one winning, you know, the Easter eggs. And then I was playing, you know, video games with my cousins and all, telling jokes. That's all I did.
I went to Mexico to see my grandparents.
Anything else?
I ate lots of good food over there. Delicious. I don't know what else to say.
I played a lot of piano. That's what I did. And slept.
Sounds like a nice weekend.
Are you going to prom?
Oh, yeah.
Ask anyone out yet?
Well, when you have the social skills of a brick wall, that's not really something you think about.
I'm sure you can have fun by yourself.
What do you mean by that?
Oh, let me show you.
Today is the last day to submit a prom nominee. If you missed the May 3rd ticket sales, don't fret. Tickets will be on sale again on May 9th and 17th, and prom royalty voting will be held from May 10th up until the 12th. Prom court will be held during homeroom at the quad on May 13th.
Here's what to expect for the event itself.
The prom reveal has revealed that this year's theme will be dreams come true. This prom will definitely live up to its name, so don't miss it. Prom itself will be held on May 21st in Newport Beach. Festivities will be held on a three-tier yacht. The first tier is an Italian buffet, the second is a dance floor with complete with a photo booth, and the third is a balcony to look up at the stars. Students should expect to leave before 5:45 p.m. as the boat leaves at 6 p.m. sharp. Students who wish to attend should remind those who will be picking them up afterwards to be back by 10:15 p.m. Prom officially ends at 10 p.m. sharp, so don't stay out too late. Hope to see you there, Pioneers!
You know what yesterday was?
May 5th?
It was Cinco de Mayo.
Cinco de Mayo?
Mayo.
Oh, yeah, that's what I said. What's that about?
Roll the clip.
Hey Pioneers, I'm Melanie.
And I'm Lucy.
And today we're going to go to Miss Ion's class to see what they made for Cinco de Mayo.
Let's get to it.
Substantially, pastel picado is those little decorations that you will see at a traditional fiesta.
It's like the little banners that you see hanging.
It's usually made out of tissue paper, but we don't have tissue paper, so that's why we're going to use construction paper. I want you to come to the front and get one piece of colored construction paper, okay? The next step you do on the construction paper, you're essentially going to fold it in half. You just want to start drawing like some designs on here that you would think will look good. You want to go actually at a 45 degree angle when you're holding the knife and you're cutting. So all you have to do is kind of hold it at a 45 angle and then put some pressure and then just follow the lines. It kind of gives you like a cleaner cut on the paper, to be honest with you guys.
And that's it for today, Pioneers. Anchors, back to you.
I think we can all relate to this particular situation.
You study for an upcoming test.
Or don't.
And when you finally get to test day,
you forget everything, if there was anything there at all.
And you freak out.
And you just accept the fact that you might not be passing this class with an A.
So here's this segment to give you some ideas on prepping for ATV testing, because we all need it, we all know it.
Are you bad at studying and you always get a low score and disappointing your legacy? Well, here are three things that you can do to prepare for the AP test in May. The first thing you can do is to go to tutoring and get help from other peers that can help you with the lessons or things that you need help on. The second thing that you can do is to suggest your teacher if you can take a mock test so that you and your peers can experience what the day is going to feel like and see what are your strengths and weaknesses. The last thing you can do is to watch videos on other teachers so that you will be able to have more knowledge and also get their side on the lessons.
Well, AP students, good luck on your tests in May.
Host, back to you.
How smart are you?
I don't know. How smart do I look? Ouch. Anyway,
let's see if our teacher high is smarter than a fifth grader.
Hey, Pioneers! I'm Lucy.
And I'm Melanie, and we're going to see if our teacher is smarter than a fifth grader.
Let's get started.
So we're here with Sydney.
And your question is, how many consonants are there?
Seven.
Correct! Are you smarter than a fifth grader?
Yeah.
Okay. What's the capital of the United States?
There is no capital of the United States. You said the capital of the U.S. Oh, wait. Is it called the capital?
And your question is, who was the 16th president of the United States?
I barely passed civics.
Take an educational guess.
Hamilton. Shoot, I don't know, bro.
The president is on the dollar bill.
George Washington.
Yes. Which war was fought between the North and South regions of the United States?
The Civil War?
Yes! If you were born 10 years ago today, how old would you be?
25.
You'd be 10 years old.
I know.
Spell refrigerator. R E I. Right? F R. I don't know.
No.
And speaking of just how smart people are,
we currently have 35 days, 10 hours, 8 minutes, 54, 53, 52, 51,
and 50. Counting! Anyway, there's a lot of problems you guys are probably going to face as seniors. And with college comes college debt, and with college debt comes...
We're getting ahead of ourselves, okay? Let's focus on problems that seniors may face at the end of the year.
Yeah, I guess like choosing classes. Like in particular, for example, welding an auto.
Attention students, we are here to inform you that summer is coming, and with that, summer courses. And I'm not talking about normal, boring old summer school. I'm talking about some videotaping, metal melting, theater acting, get your hands dirty kind of fun. These courses include Film 159, Dance 100, Theater 110, Theater 133, and Auto 140, and Welding 60 and 100. I'm here to specifically talk about great career pathway courses for both auto and welding. These courses are classes that are also offered at Cerritos College and will give you college credits. The welding courses include Welding 60 and Welding 100, and Metal Fabrication Safety and Welding Fundamentals. These courses are available to welding students only. This course will be in person at Artesia High School. The times are from 8 to 1, June 13th to July 22. The auto class is Auto 140 Steering and Suspension, Tire Balancing, and Alignment. The times will be from 8 to 1, June 13th to July 22. In taking these courses, you will be receiving college credit, certifications on specific machinery, and a payment of minimum wage. It's a win-win-win. What are you waiting for? First, go talk to your counselor if you have any questions, and second, go to Student Union and sign up. Hurry up, get it done.
Thanks for tuning in.
Before we leave this episode, we still have a joke left over from one of our Ask ATVs, and the joke is, why did the bicycle fall over?
Why?
Because it was too tired.